music, less talk. Feel the magic.
What a pleasure to welcome Ophelia Lovibond, who plays Pippi in Mr. Popper's Penguins. Now, I'm struggling to say all of that together.
Yeah, I can see.
How did you cope? Because Pippi had a bit of a penchant for pronouncing her P's.
She did. I see you do too. I did lots of tongue twisters and kind of warm-ups before they would start rolling, so I'd be all right with it. But they were really fun to say. It didn't feel like a chore to do it. It was really, when do you get the opportunity to do that on film? It was really fun.
Yeah, it's true. And of course, you're working with an absolute comedy legend as well, Jim Carrey.
Yes.
It's the question I'm sure you've been asked the most since you've done this film, but what is he actually like on set? Is he as madcap as he seems?
He's not madcap. He certainly reserves his energy for the takes, but he's really friendly, and he's actually a lot more calm than I expected, just because, you know, you're given the impression that he's just this kind of wild card the whole time, but it would be exhausting, I think, to be like that constantly. He's actually he's softly spoken. He's still very funny, but he doesn't perform all the time like that. He saves that for him.
You've done loads of films up to this point and worked with some amazing people along the way. Not only like Ray Winston and Colin Farrell, who are just, you know, I love Colin Farrell. I think he's a
snap.
Class act. He's such the time you must have had with him must have been a right laugh.
We were doing the places we were filming along the embankment, kind of opposite St Paul's and near the Globe. We were right outside the Globe at one point when we were doing one of those scenes, and you're just kind of looking around you and thinking, you know, amazing director Bill Monahan, and then working with Colin, you just kind of think, just checking that no one's going to go, ha, not really. he was incredible to work with. Really, there was so much going on all the time. Like every single take, there'd be something different that he'd be trying, and it was like a kind of being in a class or something.
You've been tipped as one of the big 50 faces to watch in Hollywood now.
The big, okay.
Well, you're not that big. one of the 5'3"-ish.
5'2.5".
Yeah, there you go. Mm-hmm. Faces to watch in Hollywood. How did that make you feel when that sort of comes out?
It's very flattering, but I think those things are quite arbitrary. I don't think you should pay too much heed by them. Because, I don't know. It's very lovely. It's really flattering, but it would be the films I do I'd like people to respond to. I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but I just think that those, they come and go, this sort of thing, so I wouldn't get belief hype.
Ophelia, lovely to meet you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so
and the best of luck with this and the rest of your career as well.
Thank you, that's very nice. Put it in your hand, Hollywood is dead.
More music, less talk. Feel the magic.